Apple Notes is chock full of amazing features and functions, but one of my favorites is the ability to share and collaborate in real time with a note from your iPhone. Want to know how? Stick around. I'm Dylan Stewart, the Mac Whisperer, and in this video, we're going to continue our conversation about all the different features and functions in Apple's Notes app. In this video, we're going to focus on how to share and collaborate from the app. Stick around for my MacWhisperer Power Tip because I'm going to reveal a tool that will allow you to share multiple documents with multiple people with ease. This video is going to cover two completely separate topics. The first one is sharing. Sharing is the ability to send a note from your phone in multiple different ways, but it also includes the ability of sharing two notes from other applications like Safari or even Photos. Collaboration is about sharing a document with one or more people and having them work on that document with you in real time. Both sharing and collaborating are critical tools. Let's start off with sharing. First thing we're going to do is jump into the Notes app right here. Here we've got a note ready to go. If I'd like to share it, all I have to do is click on the share icon in the upper right corner of the screen. This gives me tons of options, but the first thing we need to pay attention to is this option where it currently says collaborate. If I click on that, I can choose either collaborate or send a copy. We'll talk about collaboration in just a few minutes, but first let's talk about sending a copy. There's many ways for you to share this document. Across the top bar here, you're gonna see the faces of many of the people you've spoken to recently or that you speak to frequently. And by simply clicking on their picture, you can send this document as a text or as an email, depending on the little image that you see at the bottom right of their photo. Across the bottom bar, you can press the AirDrop button to send this document out to any Apple devices that are nearby. If you do send it out via text or email, it's going to send it out not as a notes document, but as the text of the document, just like this, adding it into your message chain and allowing you to send it out as straight text. Now be aware, if you have a lot of photos in the note, they may not show up in the right place, so it may not be the best way to share a complicated note. But if you're sharing a note that just has text in it, sending it via text or sending it by mail is super, super simple. You can also share to many other apps like the Reminders app. Clicking on this button will allow you to schedule that note to pop up on your phone or other devices at a specific day or time. This can be really helpful if the note has information you need tomorrow at 8 a.m. Rather than hunting for that note at the time, set it up as a reminder and it will show up for you, and all you'll have to do is click on it. In addition to sending it to reminders, you can send it to the Journal app or to the Freeform app, or even upload it to Facebook or Google Chat or all sorts of other options. If you swipe to the far right side, you'll see this More button where you can customize what apps show up on that bottom bar, making it even easier for you to send a note to any application you like. But that's not the only way you can share. If you swipe up on the screen, you're going to see a ton of other options, including the ability to print to any Wi-Fi printers in your network. Simply clicking this button will open up the print screen, giving you the ability to choose your printer and many of the options for printing out this document. But there's a secret power tip hidden on this page. Sometimes you may have a note that you want to export into a PDF. This makes it much easier for other people to see it. So if you've got a note that's got lots of photos and other information in it, rather than sending it via text, consider making it into a PDF so it looks the same for them as it does on your device. To do that, come into the print screen like we are right here and go back to the share button at the top. Down here, you'll notice that this document has already been converted into a PDF. Now I can send it as a PDF via text or email, or even save it into my file so that I can find it on my computer or my iPad at a later point. This makes it so easy to take that note and share it in all sorts of ways so that you can have it in your reminders, as an email, as a text, or as a PDF. One of the other ways that we can share things is not sharing them from notes, but sharing them to notes from other applications. Maybe you're on a web page and you'd like to capture this information and save it for later. Sure, you could bookmark this web page, but then it would get lost in the shuffle with all of your other bookmarks. It's easy to send it to notes by clicking the share button at the bottom. If you click on the Notes app, it will take that web page and drop it into the note. You can choose to send it to a new note, or by clicking up here, you can select any of the notes in your notes library. In this case, it's fine to send it to a new note. You can even add a little bit of text at the top so that you know what that website is pertaining to. When you're done, click the Save button in the upper right-hand corner. Now let's go take a look at that note. Let's swipe out of Safari and into Notes. I'm going to come into my All iCloud folder. And right there is our tips on using AirPlay with the link right here. Now, anytime I want to, I can press on that link and it will jump me into that web page. But there's even other ways you can share from Safari and other apps into Notes. For this example, I'm going to select some of the text on this particular web page. From right here, there's a pop-up menu. If I click on this arrow, you'll notice the option to create a new quick note. A quick note is a note that comes to the app you're in so that you don't have to leave Safari to go to Notes. I'm gonna click here, and it's gonna capture all of that information in this new note. This is better than just sharing the link because it's got the actual text right on the note, so I can click on that text to go to the website, but I can also just read it. Let's click Save and check it out. I'm gonna swipe up, go back into Notes. Let's click our back arrow till we get to the Folders screen. And up at the top, we've got our quick note. There it is, ready for us to get into, read, or click on it to jump back to that web page. But it doesn't just happen with Safari. You can do that same thing in all sorts of other apps. For example, maybe you've got an email that you'd like to capture inside of Notes. Right from here, you can pull down from your upper right-hand corner to get to your control center and choose the quick note icon. You'll see it right here. If you don't see the quick note icon, press and hold on your screen, click Add a Control, and search for it. Once you click the quick note icon, it brings up a brand new fresh note with the ability up at the top to add the link to what you're looking at. In this case, it's adding the link to that email. As I click it here, it puts the link right at the top of the note. Now I can click Save, come back into Notes here, and here's our new note with a link into that email. I can click on it and it will take me to that email. But you can even do that from Photos. Let's open up Photos here and let's click on this image here. I'm going to click the Share button in the lower left-hand corner, and once again, there's Notes. Clicking on it will allow me to choose a new note or add it to an existing one. In this case, let's add it to the AirPlay note. I'm going to click Save in the upper right-hand corner. Let's go back into Notes. And here that image is right on the note itself. There's other ways that you can share directly into Notes as well. You can always press and hold on anything you'd like and copy it and then paste it in Notes. But if you have two hands free, you can also drag and drop. Press and hold on that image and keep the finger held down so that that image is being held onto. Then using your other finger, swipe back on the bottom bar to get into that note, and you can drop it in that way. It's not just photos that you can do that with, you can also do that with text. So if you happen to be on that email and you don't just want the link to the email, you want the text of it, you can select all the text you want, press and hold on it, keep your finger down, swipe back to your Notes app, and drop it right in. That makes it so easy to share information from almost any app directly into Notes. Now, let's talk about collaboration. Collaboration is so important, and technology makes it easy to collaborate in a number of ways. Maybe you're texting or emailing with someone to make a plan, or maybe you're creating a Google document and everyone's going onto that document to add their information in. But you don't need to do that through text or email or even Google anymore. You can do it through Apple. Collaborating is simple. Come to the note that you want to collaborate with and click the Share button. For this note, my wife and I are planning a dinner party, and I need her help to build out all the information to make the party a success. Let's click on the Share button right here. This time it says Collaborate, and that's just fine because that's exactly what I want to do. If you see the person you want to collaborate down on your list, you can send it that way, or you can email or text them. In this case, my wife's right there, so let's click on her picture, and it opens up the invite to edit and collaborate on this note right into text. Let's click Send. Once you've created a shared note, you'll notice in the upper right-hand corner when other people are active on the note. Clicking on this icon right up here can allow you to see who's on the note with you and also keep track of the changes that they're making. You can click to show all activity as people make edits, and they'll show up right here. Or you can also come here and show highlights of what's being done, or click the Manage Shared Note button in order to add additional people to it, hide alerts for this note, or copy the link to share it with others. Now, my wife and I are both on this note, so let's start planning this dinner party. Come down here where we're talking about who we want to bring, and I'm going to click on the column button right here. That's going to give me an easy table that I can use to invite people and suggest who we want to have come. I'm going to say I want Doug to come, and I'm going to say that I want Judy to come. And then I can click the three dots, the left side here, in order to add additional rows, or I can just type in the next thing and click the next button and it will create additional rows for me. As people say yes or no, we can put their information in right here. As we come down here, we might want to be talking about choosing the menu. What kind of food do we want? How do we want to make the meal? And we can automatically tag in any links to any other notes we've got. That can be done really easily by pressing your number button and then the symbol button here and double click the greater than symbol. This will tie you into any existing notes so that I can come in and look for that chicken recipe that I like and add the link to it right here. Simple and easy. Now you can tag whatever you want into there. We can also add photographs or all sorts of other information. And as we work back and forth, we can even have conversations about things. If I want to notify my wife of a particular question, I can come in, hit my number button and the at symbol, and right up at the top, it'll show anybody that's in this note, in this case, my wife. And then I can continue to ask her a question. As we work on this, she can add information and I can add information in real time. Here she's put in some pictures of what we'd like the table to look like. Here she's adding some cool drink recipes along with links to the website specifically for that recipe. I can come in and tell her what I think. Don't forget to make it fun. You can easily come in and add any emojis that you want by just clicking on the suggestions on your toolbar here to make it super simple for all of us to beautify this note and make it perfect. Now, as we continue to make changes and edits on this note, both of us are alerted in real time. And if I'm not nearby my phone or not using notes, I can keep track of what changes have been made by clicking up on the share icon up here. And you'll see that we're both editing the note. Julie was mentioned. Here are some of the participants. I can even see where she's typing. Look right there and you'll see that she's putting in the playlist and other information. You don't have to use Google Docs to do this kind of collaboration anymore. You can make it easy to make a note beautiful and to make sure that everyone's on the same page with the same note, making changes in real time so that everybody's working together to build an unbelievable dinner party. So as you can see, Notes is a super powerful tool and it can be used as a great replacement for Google Docs or for emailing and texting documents back and forth. It's all in-house, it's all on your Apple devices and it makes it so simple. But there's something that I left out. Right, it's the power tip. In just a moment, I'm going to reveal a power tip that takes everything we talked about up to the next level, making it easier than ever to share multiple documents with multiple people. But before I do that, if you got great value out of today's video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. That just makes it so much easier for other people to find it. And if you've got questions, comments, or you want to come to my dinner party, drop it down in the comments section. I love to hear from you guys, and I'm always happy to help you make the most of your Apple products. And if you love this video and some of the things you're learning about Apple devices, rather than hunting around for YouTube videos and hoping to find mine, hit that subscribe button and that notify bell so that you're always alerted whenever I drop new content and it can be delivered directly to your inbox so that I can help you make the most out of all your Apple products. And so now, you know what time it is? It's power tip time. It's fantastic that we can share a note and collaborate with anyone. But if you're doing a lot of collaboration, it's annoying to keep sharing documents again and again and again. And there's a great solution that makes that super simple. To do that, let's back out into our folders view here. As we talked about in the organizational video and some of the other videos in this playlist, we use folders to sort and organize all sorts of things, making it easy to find what you're looking for without having to search for it all the time. But that same folder tool can also be used for collaboration. I'm going to create a new folder by clicking on the new folder button in the lower left corner here. Let's call it Julie. There the folder is. Now let's share the folder with Julie. By pressing and holding on the folder, I get some options, including the share button. Let's click share here, and let's text the invitation to Julie and click send. As soon as she joins that folder, it means that any notes that I'm working on that we need to collaborate on together can be dragged directly in there. I'm going to click the three dots here and let's select some notes, this one, this one, this one, and of course our dinner party. Let's click the move button in the lower left-hand corner here and let's drop it into our Julie folder. It warns me that it may change some of the permissions, but that's okay because I'm sharing them with Julie over here as well. As I move them over, they'll disappear from this section and show up instead in the Julie folder. Julie can also add her own notes into here at any given time, meaning that if I create the note here or add it here, it's automatically shared. And it's not restricted to just one person. I can come up to our little share icon, notated right now by Julie's face, and I can manage this shared folder. From here, I can add other people onto this list, making sure that my entire family can collaborate on specific documents without having to jump through hoops or send out Google Documents. You know, one of my problems with Google Documents is that when somebody shares a Google Doc with you, it gets sent to you as an email. Most people save that email because they're afraid they'll never be able to find that document without that email. This is because Google Drive is disorganized and complicated, and it's always really hard to find the things that have been shared with you. But if you're using Apple Notes, and especially using a shared folder, it's right here. I don't need to track it with a text message or an email. All I have to do is come into my shared folder whenever I need to update it or see what new information is there. A simple click, and here's Julie's t-shirt note that she's added in with all of this other information for us to work on together. It's a great way to collaborate and also a great way to avoid having to use Google Docs when Apple Notes will do just fine. So that's what we've got for today's video about how to share and collaborate with Notes. Check out this video for more amazing tips on how to make the most out of all of your Apple devices. I'm Dylan Stewart, the Mac Whisperer, and I'll see you in the comments.